Since all my current projects are taking longer than expected, I thought I would use No Effort November as an excuse to make a quick little video I've been thinking about for a while. Depending on the result, I might make one or two more, but don't worry, there are still plenty of ridiculous Adoparsec shop action still cooking at the moment. We'll start with a simple question. Why do mirrors reflect things left to right and not top to bottom? And I'll answer that with a flaming hot take. They actually do reflect things top to bottom, not left to right as you've always thought. And I can prove it. So over the years, I've seen a lot of explanations about why mirrors reverse things the way they do. Did anyone else ever watch the old Newton's Apple show on PBS?
Welcome to Newton's Apple.
I loved that show. It had a segment on mirrors which particularly stuck with me, which I only now realize was a Shelley Duvall guest appearance. It emphasized how flat mirrors don't cross light rays or anything like that. It's just reversing their direction. So it's as if you're seeing everything reflected in them from behind. Illustrated with text on a transparent panel, the effect seems quite obvious. The panel isn't rotated in any way, it's just translated from behind your head to in front of your head, at which point the text is going to be reversed. Simple. And yet, why left to right? What does the local orientation of gravity have to do with anything shown above? None of the explanations I ever saw address that. And at the risk of being needlessly contrarian, I think I have an answer. The key is to ask, how do you know what something behind you is supposed to look like? We have to determine that before we can ask any questions about what the mirror is doing, after all. Now, this might seem a bit obvious, but pretend you're an alien, completely unfamiliar with our world. You are looking in a mirror, and you can see that there's something behind you. Now, us Earthlings immediately recognize it as a stop sign, but you don't know what that is, and you don't know what it's supposed to look like. What do you do to compare it to its reflection? You turn around, of course. At which point, you can see the stop sign and compare it with its reflection and see that it was mirrored left to right. But that's still thinking in very human-centric terms. What if instead of turning around like a human would, you did this instead? Now you see this. Compared with the reflection before, it has been mirrored top to bottom. And thus our alien friend here can conclude, entirely logical, with irrefutable empirical evidence that mirrors reflect top to bottom, not left to right. Is turning around by bending over to look through your own legs normal? No, it's incredibly awkward. But that's an arbitrary issue of the human body. Abstractly speaking, we're tall, narrow cylinders. Turning about the z-axis is just the obvious choice. Everything about our environment reinforces that too. Many of you watching this video will be sitting on chairs with a built-in z-axis pivot already. The last time you pivoted about any other axis might have been doing somersaults in grade school. If that's a bit much for you, what if you just reached back to grab the stop sign? How do you bring it to the front to look at it? Again, you'd probably yaw around the z-axis. But an alien might well pitch it around x, bringing it into view looking like this. Once again, the question of what a mirror does to the image depends entirely on what rotation is being used. So, yeah, the choice of z-rotation is so natural that we hardly ever even consider that there are other options. But there are other options, and the geometry doesn't care, and the universe certainly doesn't care. If we had a different body design, or lived suspended in water, or just developed weirdly specific taboos about the correct way to rotate, then we would just as naturally conclude that mirrors reflect things top to bottom. And we wouldn't be wrong. The real lesson to be learned here is that the original question was poorly phrased. Mirrors don't reflect about a specific axis. They merely show you what's behind you. It's up to you to decide what its correct orientation is. I don't know, maybe this is pushing the no-effort format a bit too far? Let me know what you think. At least I got to play with some new lighting toys in the process. So, as always, cheers.